What happens 5 days past ovulation?
If you use natural family planning, everything you didn't do the day or so after ovulation or the week before that point for fear of getting pregnant.
There is an old joke that the word for women who use natural family planning is mother.
The uterine lining is in the early middle of the luteal phase.
That's the fancy word for the uterine lining is building to make full contact with an embryo.
The hormones for building up that blood flow are arcing up and will start to fall around day 21.
When the level drops down to baseline, that's what triggers your menstrual cycle.
The pituitary gland is silent right now on hormone production.
It is only involved when the hormones that trigger the release of a fertilized egg are released themselves. That's the day you ovulate.
The follicle that released the egg is in the corpus luteum stage, shrinking down to nothing.
I've heard of women with polycystic ovaries having pains when they ovulate because so many are out.
For the average woman, you may or may not have a twinge when it releases an egg.
Fewer than 10% do.
And while that follicle is collapsing into nothing, you feel nothing. Oh, and the basal body temperature right now is still high but will fall around the start of the menstrual cycle.
It is usually high from day 14 to day 28, going from 36 to 37 degrees Celsius before dropping back down.
So you track your basal body temperature?
No. Since you have to do it while still in bed but not trapped up under too many layers and hopefully didn't throw it off getting up to go to the bathroom.
The menstrual cycle starts with the proliferation of the uterine tissue, the proliferative phase. It is now officially in the middle of the secretory phase.
The fancy word for when the egg doesn't implant, you'll secrete all that as your period.
If you did have an egg get fertilized, it is moving down the fallopian tube and will implant today at the earliest. Probably in the next few days.
It has to in the next week and a half or the period will start.
It starts to put out the chemical signal saying it is there to prevent your period starting, though that won't show up in blood tests for days.
I heard the hormone levels double every day or two.
Remember that urine tests have to pick up what is in your blood and passes through the urine, so a blood test could pick the pregnancy hormone up well before a urine test.
I knew that much. And the early pregnancy tests pick up the pregnancy hormone at half the level the cheaper pregnancy tests.
But no pregnancy test will see that you're pregnant right now.
Then all I can do is wait for a sign, though whether a plus on a pregnancy test or my period starting.
There are also immune system factors that prevent the mother's body from rejecting the embryo, though that test isn't something you can get over the counter.
There are plenty of others on the shelf I can get to use in a few days.